Hey friends, did you know that verifiable credentials in Azure Active Directory enables you to prove that you are you on the internet while keeping your credentials and your information private? Engineer Cindy Morton is going to tell me how this works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. Today I've got software engineer Cindy Morton here to tell me all about Azure verifiable credentials as a service. That's a thing I didn't know existed. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's super cool, super new. We just got to public preview a couple weeks ago, actually. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so my understanding of decentralized identity is kind of limited, and I see though that recently, just as a user, I'm having to enter my password a lot less. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing a lot more QR codes, and I'm seeing a lot more verification of who I am by using my phone. Like I get a notification on my phone, and I look at it. And it uses biometrics, whether it be my touch ID or my face ID or whatever. And it's like, oh, well, I guess you knew that it was me. Yeah, that was cool.
Totally. The world is definitely moving to passwordless because passwords are not great. They're hard to remember and you have so many of them. So we're trying to create a passwordless world based on open standards, for
okay.
sure.
So then you brought me a bunch of demos to explain how this public preview of verifiable credentials as a service works, because that's really what it's all about is the demos mm-hmm. and explaining essentially how does this work and why is it secure? Because, you know, my non-technical partner is kind of like, I don't know what's going on. When do I enter my password? It doesn't feel intuitive. You're going to make it intuitive.
Yeah. So our kind of goal for this solution was to create a secure but privacy preserving solution, but also it has to be super convenient and transparent to the user. I mean, signing into things, that's not why you actually are trying to like go onto the internet. It's just like kind of a barrier to get to where you want to go. So we want to make it as convenient as possible, but also super secure. And our solution also, it really, the user right now, all of the passwords, all of the information is kind of owned by third parties. So you sign in, you're going through an IDP. An identity provider. So for us, we want to kind of put the control back into the user. So the user controls their credentials, they control their data, and we just give it all back to the user.
That's a great point. The identity provider point is a really interesting one. I never realized until I was signing up for some classes and I ended up using another third-party identity provider. And I was like, wow, I hope that I always have access to that third-party identity provider.
Right.
Or I'm going to lose access to all these other things that I use.
Exactly. They have complete control of your data. Plus, you don't really know exactly what claims they have about you. So we kind of want to like have a more transparent relationship with the user. So they know what claims they own, and it's completely transparent inside of their application.
Okay, let's go ahead and share your screen and see the demo.
Awesome. So this is a typical demo. We're building an entire platform for decentralized identity and verifiable credentials, but we believe this workplace credentials is going to be a very common use case for technology. So right here, we are in the Woodgrove employee portal, and we're signed in as Matthew Michael. And you can scan this QR code to get their Woodgrove employee verifiable credential. We use the Authenticator app because that's where all of passwordless is, all of your signing in information is. So we thought this is the perfect app to add verifiable credentials. Type in your employee ID, add credential, and you can see now that you have a verified Woodgrove employee credential inside of your Authenticator app.
Okay, so hang on, let me ask a question then, because as soon as I saw the QR code, I was like, I'm gonna take a picture and I'm gonna steal Matthew Michael's identity.
Yeah.
And then I saw you enter in an employee ID, I wouldn't have had that.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So right now you can see on the screen, you have the employee ID number just as the demo, but that could be a text message or an email that only you have. So that's a security measure we have taken to prevent some sort of attack like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, I just got into my Microsoft Authenticator app and I'm stuck at this point. So even though I was looking over your shoulder, mm-hmm. I was not able to steal that ID and break into the company.
Exactly. Something else interesting about the verifiable credential is you can actually see all of the claims about you that is contained inside the verifiable credential. And you can see when it was issued on, when it expires, and who it was issued from. So it's super transparent. And then you can also see recent activity. So it was issued by Woodgrove. We haven't really presented it yet. So very, very transparent to the user again. So next, I want to show how you can actually go to a third party, something that some company that has nothing to do with Woodgrove, and you can actually access a corporate discount by presenting your Woodgrove employee card because they might be partners.
Literally did this. I'm picking up a TV on Sunday.
Yeah.
And it was a whole dance between logging into Microsoft, and it was a dance between identity providers. So you just are literally showing me a scenario that I did like days ago.
Yeah, it's super, super relevant. I do this all the time too. And there's no federation that needs to go on. Woodgrove doesn't have to know about Prosware requesting their credential. Prosware will know as soon as we, you know, send our credential over to them that Michael, who is this person, is a Woodgrove employee. You can also see, just in case you want to, again, what claims are in the card. So what information you're actually presenting to Prosware. So I can allow and I can send this request, this response. And there you go. Now you have a corporate discount count applied.
Okay, so help me understand this. So federation, I'm familiar with, where I'm at the Prosware site, I say, hey, I'm a Microsoft employee or whatever, and I click a button, I hop over to one website, I tell them that, and then they go and say, yeah, we're cool with that guy. Mm-hmm. And it's like the transitive property of friendship. Like me and exactly. Sydney are cool, and Sydney and so-and-so are cool, therefore I'm cool with so-and-so, and it's a whole dance. Mm-hmm. But you didn't. You like inserted your card in a slot, and you said, this is me.
This is exactly. So Prosware was requesting a verifiable credential issued by Woodgrove, and they were able to understand exactly what verifiable credential they wanted based on a type. And Woodgrove is not involved at all, so they don't have to even worry about it.
Okay. And did they use like a SDK? What's in, like, there's some magic in the certificate.
Exactly. Okay. So it's so interesting because this is based on open standards. So the developer at Prosware could actually implement all the crypto operations, everything behind the scenes, all the protocol, because it's based on OpenID Connect. But we don't think that a typical developer would want to deal with all of that stuff. Again, we're trying to focus on the convenience of the user and also the developer experience. So we actually created a client API that actually deals with all the crypto operations, all of the protocol, and they only have to make one API call in order to request verifiable credentials.
I personally set up OpenID and OpenID Connect by reading the spec, and we worked on this on our blogs to make it so people could log into OpenID, and it was not one line of code. It was like a thing, and that's why it never took off.
Yeah, so something we actually learned in private preview, we actually had an SDK that did this, and it was based in Node. Something we got from our customers was that they really wanted a client API, something super simple, that where their backend could be any language they wanted, and they just have to make a call to our API, and then we deal with everything else. So that was definitely a learning we learned during private preview. But this is the API call. You can choose to even include the QR code, and it has all of like the security properties and everything. And this is the just requesting the credential. So you want a Woodgrove verified employee credential. Say they eventually maybe want a Microsoft verified employee credential, they could just add it to this data object array and you could request that as well. And then returned is just this URL. And this is actually based on OpenID Connect. And this is actually what is encoded in the QR code that you saw me scan. Yeah, it's very simple.
I'm just trying to, like, it's like, I see that it's words, but it's not human readable, but that's the secret sauce. That's the magic in there. But totally. I see though that there is it's interesting that the URL is a protocol handler, right?
Yeah. So you can actually use it to deep link to the authenticator app or just encode it in a QR code and cameras can pick it up and know they need to go to the authenticator app.
Yeah, I noticed that when I took the photograph on my iPhone, it said automatically, I'll open this in Authenticator.
Yes.
It's because Authenticator registered itself as the protocol handler and the phone just said, I'll just launch that URL. HTTP goes to Edge and OpenID colon whack whack goes over to
the Authenticator app. Exactly. Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, it's super cool. So that's how you request and verify verifiable credentials as a relying party. But there's one more missing piece, and that is issuance of verified credentials. So how does a Woodgrove admin actually create a way to issue a Woodgrove verified employee credential. And we created this verifiable credentials as a service, and this is the admin experience. So what I will do is I will actually create this, show how easy it is by creating a verifiable credential right there, right now for you guys. Mm-hmm. So what we do is you type in your name, so that would be Woodgrove, type in a domain. So this domain is used to provide trust between the issuer of the credential and the user. Mm-hmm. And then we select a key vault. So something about our services is that we're completely stateless. We don't deal with the keys. As a Microsoft, we don't deal with the keys. The Azure Key Vault is in the tenant of Woodgrove, of the issuer. And we also don't deal with any data. We're completely stateless as a service, as an issuance service. Once we do this, we save and create the credential. And we create a verified employee credential. And this is where all of the information comes, is right here. We have two files we need to upload, the display file. And this kind of shows the look and feel of the credential inside of the authenticator app.
People think about cards. They want to feel like there's a card.
Exactly. And then we have the rules file. So this is the requirements needed in order to issue a credential.
And how will I get these things? I know that I can draw a picture of a card, but how do I get these JSON files?
So we're going to create a, this is going, these files are just for right now. We're actually going to create a form fill, and we're going to have an interactive wizard actually shows you the card. That's coming pretty soon.
Cool.
So once we have uploaded both of these files, we can go create. And it is literally as simple as that. And now you're able to issue verified employee cards.
And we're using the example of employees, but correct me if I'm wrong, mm-hmm. It could be my Chipotle taco card. It could be if I have an AD for my own home because I've got Azure AD and I've set it up for the family here, it could be to open a smart lock. Like credentials are whatever you choose them to be.
Exactly. We are building a platform for verifiable credentials and an ecosystem for decentralized identity. So, you know, customers and relying parties can really use this to create anything they want. We're just kind of making it easier for them to do that.
Mm-hmm. Cool. I just want to make sure that we understand that it's not just about employee cards, right? It's about it's about the virtualization of all this physical crap that I have in my, you know, in my wallet right here, which is a bunch of physical cards that I'm always carrying around. This is cool.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. So we can see this. You can see, I see it says beta inside of the Microsoft Authenticator app, which you're using right there.
Yes. Yes.
Folks can go learn about this. We're going to put links in the show notes to learn all about verifiable credentials that you'll find on the Azure website underneath Active Directory. This is in preview, public preview.
Yes.
So people out there who have an Azure AD and are using the Microsoft Authenticator app, they can start playing with this right away.
Right away. Please, we would love to see more people get more involved.
All right.
Get feedback.
And I assume that there's feedback links in the portal that go to actual real humans like you that can help them be successful.
Yeah, definitely.
Fantastic. I am learning all about verifiable credentials as a service today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.